Hello friends, welcome to my channel MN Coaching Center. So today I'm going to explain Chartered Accounts first chapter, meaning and scope of accounting, part 2 video. So last video I stopped here. So objective of accounting, let us continue from here. So objective of accounting, the objective of accounting can be given as follow: systematic recording of transaction. Basic objective of accounting is to you have to record it systematically, record the aspects of the business transaction. You have to keep bookkeeping in your hand. You have to do, and this recording transaction or later on classified, it should be classified and summarized logically for the preparation of final statements, and for their analysis and interpretation it should be used further. Next is the ascertainment of results of above recorded transaction. So accounting, it prepares profit and loss accounts to know the results of that business operation, but for a period of time, like 1 month or year, for that time, they will make the, to know about the profit and loss of their company, they will make the accounting, as you know. So it revenue exceed expenses. If the revenue of that company, if it get exceeded than their expenses, then it is said that business is running profitably. But if expenses is getting more and revenue of that company is getting low, then we can say it as the company is going in loss. So the profit and loss account of that company helps for the management and different stakeholders who are there in that company to take a correct decision. And like example, let us take an example. If business is not proved to be profitable, the cause of such a state of affairs will be investigated and managed for, it will be taken more steps, new steps, new ideas they will make to get profit. Next, ascertainment of the financial position of the business. So businessman is not only interested in knowing the results of the business in terms of profit or loss, in terms of profit or loss for a particular period of time, but they are also anxious to know that what he wants, what businessman, what he is having, what I am having, he wants to know. What he owes, whether it is liabilities to the outsiders, and what he owes, whether it is assets, whether he is getting profit or loss. He should be knowing that, because he is the owner or the stakeholder of the company. He has a right to know about whether his company is getting profit or loss. So to know this, the accountants prepare their financial position statements, that is known as the balance sheet. And the balance sheet is, it is a statement of assets and liabilities of that business in a particular point of time, and that will help them for ascertaining, for giving them the financial health of for that business. Next, providing information to the users for rational decision making. So as accounting is a language called as the language of business, it communicates the financial results of enterprise with the various stakeholders by the means of the financial statements. Accounting that aims for to meet the information that are needed for making the decision and helps for the taking the right decisions. Next, to know the solvency position means, by preparing the balance sheet, management, they not only reveal what he's owned and owed, means what is profit and liability assets, not that much, but by the enterprise, for not for the enterprise, it does not helps to know about the profit and loss, that's all, but it also gives them about the information regarding to the what they are meeting the liabilities in the short liquidity positions, and also in the long run, and when they fall due, what all the problems they are facing. It will helps them to know, the accounting will helps them to know that. So, one minute, it is a little bit stuck. Okay, so like this only, we can demonstrate it an overview. In a chart view, we can see it. So, object of accounting, there are four objectives: systematic recording of transaction, ascertainment of results, ascertainment of financial position, and communicating information to various users. In the system of recording of transaction, you have to do bookkeeping, general ledger, trial balance. But in ascertain of results, you have to start manufacturing, trading, profit and loss accounts you have to make. Next, ascertainment of financial position, you have to make that balance sheet. And communicating information to various users, you have to make the financial report to them. Next, what are the functions of accounting? You know why we are about the different things what you have to do in the accounting. But what are their functions? Let us know about the main functions. Measurement. So the accounting, it helps the owner to measure the past performance of the business entity and depicts its current financial position. So by seeing accountings, the business management, the manager can see, or the owner can see what past performance was there, whether it is going in the loss, it was going in the last and past year, and now in this year, it was whether if it was going to the profit, then he can compare past and now present accounting status, what is his company, and he can say about where their financial position is, whether they are getting profit or loss. For seeing that, the accounting helps them. Next, forecasting. So accounting helps in forecasting future performance, financial position of the enterprise using past days. So accounting helps us see, you can 1 year if you take to accounting, that years if you can do, you will not throw it, you will keep that in your office, in your company's storeroom or where you will keep. So by seeing the last years, you can say about the future, last year and present performance, you can say whether how it will be in future, whether will it be profit or will it be loss, the company will be going in profit or loss. And financial position of the enterprise, you can say how in which position is it leading, whether it is going to profit or loss, or which position it is leading, you can say by using the past data, the data you have stored in the last year. Next, decision making. So accounting, as you know, it gives the management or the manager or the owner of that company to take the right decisions so that the company may go for the profit, and also you should take the decisions that will make new ideas so that the company may get the profit. Next, comparison and evaluation. So accounting assesses performance to achieve in relation to targets and discloses information regarding to accounting policy and contingent liabilities, which plays an important role in predicting, comparing and evaluating the financial results. So last year accounting status of that company and this year present year's accounting status, when you compare, you will know about the profit and loss, and also you will evaluate it, how is our situation, what we have to do, new ideas, many things you will learn. Next, control. Another function of accounting is control. Accounting also identifies the weakness of the operational system and provides feedbacks regarding to effectiveness of measures adopted to check such weakness. So accounting, it gives control and it will say here you are weak, here you have to get strong. As in studies you see, here in this subject you are weak, you have to get more strong, here you have to study well. Like that only they are accountings, it helps here. This we are in this place, we are not getting profit, whether in the share market or anything. Here, we are not getting profit. Here, you have to get a little bit strong, you have to use good tactics, and you have to take new ideas so that you can get profit from there. Like that, accountings will help the manager to take to get good control on their business and to help them to make profit. Next, government regulations and taxation. So accounting provides necessary information to the government to exercise control on their entity as well as collection of tax revenue. So government regulations and taxation. So accounting, they will also have information about how much tax we are giving to the government, what are the guidelines necessary by the government so that we have to follow that, so that the government not put any penalty on us. That will be followed by the accounting book. Next, bookkeeping. So bookkeeping, it is a main activity that is concerned with the recording of the financial data, whether it is relating to the business operations in a significant and orderly manner, whether it is in orderly manner. It covers procedural aspects of accounting work and embrace as to keeping that record for that function in recorded. And obviously bookkeeping produces a very count produce sorry procedures or count, it was very count by the end product, by the end product of financial statement. So in India, the term financial statement means the profit and loss and balance sheet, and it including it has some schedules and notes forming part of accountings. So as we discussed in the earlier, profit and loss account gives result of whether economic activities for a period and balance sheet of the states and the financial position of that company, or they what they are getting in that state, how much they are earning revenue, expenditure, how much they are getting revenue. They will get everything in the end of that period, like a month or a year, what period they have chosen. Bookkeeping, it also requires a suitable classification between the transactions and events, and also it is also determined, it has some reference to the for the requirements of the financial statement. It has some reference, they will give reference for the financial statement. This year you are getting wrong, here you are getting correct, use this much plan more and more in the other places, like that. And also a bookkeeping may be responsible for keeping all the records of that business. You can keep all the records of that business and you can check it again if you have some doubt in that, or only a minor segment such as position of the customer account, accounts in a departmental stores, they will be there. And a substantial portion of bookkeeping work is of a clerical nature and is increasing, it is being increasingly being accomplished through the use of mechanical and electronical device. It is been growing because now you don't keep book, you have computer there, you will be have Microsoft Excel or Microsoft Word. In that Microsoft Excel you will save that. By the mechanical and electronical device, now accounting has become a little bit easier, and accounting is based on careful and efficient bookkeeping system. Also, it is based. So now there will be still in some places in the village sites there will be bookkeeping, and in the urban side there will be the computers where they will store the information. Now, next, the essential idea behind the ideas of the past people behind the bookkeeping record is to get them to know in which position they are, and they are head of income and expenditure or not they are getting. And a business may purchase goods on credit as well as to cash also. The business can purchase their goods as credit as well as cash also. They can purchase their goods. And when the goods are brought on credit, a record must be kept of that person. They may kept that record of that person to whom the money is owed or given, to whom they given that money. And the proprietors of the business may like to know for time to time. They will keep knowing who, to whom they are given, how much they are given, what amount is due on credit, what amount we should give, purchased, and to whom we have to do. And it proper record is may not maintained. If it does not maintain, it is not possible to know about the transaction in regard to the expenses, how much we have done, and therefore the revenue also will not know. So it is very important to keep bookkeeping, or you should maintain through computers also. And at the end of the accounting period, the proprietors wants to know, or they will know how much profit has been earned and loss has been accrued due to the during that period, during that year. For this, a lot of information is needed to gather in that record of the transaction. A record of the transaction should be kept in that book, and therefore in bookkeeping, the proper maintenance of books of account is indispensable for any business. For any business, you have to keep proper recording of the book you should keep. Now, next, so at CPT level, the major concern of the curriculum is with the bookkeeping and preparation of financial statement. With the bookkeeping and financial statement only it goes ahead. So it seems important to mention at this point that it is important that book to mention that at this point, in this point, that bookkeeping and preparation of financial statements, it has a legal implication also, because maintenance of books of accounts and the preparation of financial statement of the company is according to the guideline that by the Companies Act in 2013 and Cooperative Society by Cooperative Society Act, banks and insurance companies by special acts, and many other acts are there in the laws, so that you will be having the bookkeeping. It is important in the legal also, it is important. However, for sole proprietorship and partnership business, there is no specific legislation regarding to maintain of books of account, they, because it is solo, only one is holding there, and preparation of financial statement is also not there. However, the Income Tax Act 1961 requires the maintenance of books of accounts. In some case, they will ask, they need the maintenance of books of accounts. Next, objective. What is the things of objective, main important thing of keeping the books, bookkeeping? Next, main object of bookkeeping is complete recording of transaction. It is concerned with the complete and permanent record of all transaction in a system. You should be having complete record of transaction, and permanent it should be there, and logical manner it should be to show that financial effect on the business, to show about that you should have a logical, it should, there should be a logic in that why you have given, why we have taken that money, logical should be there, and ascertain of financial effect of that on the business. It is concerned with the combined effect of all the transaction. It is combined effect of all the transaction that are made during the accounting period, and the financial position of the business as a whole, it plays an important role. Next, what are the difference between bookkeeping and accounting? So some people, they mistake that bookkeeping and accounting to be synonymous terms. It is synonymous, but in fact they both are different things from each other. How means, accounting is a broad subject, it's not a small, like a bookkeeping, a 1-2 pages or one to two chapters will really not get. It is a broad, you have to learn, see CA you are learning, it's broad, you have to learn for more years, you should know it not finishes in 1 or 2 chapters. So it calls for a greater understanding about the recordings obtained from the bookkeeping, about the recording, what you get from the bookkeeping. It in accounting you will learn about that, and an ability also you will get by accounting to analyze and interpret it, how to interpret that information what you have got by get by the accountings, and also provide you will take that information provided by the bookkeeping records also. And bookkeeping, it is a recording phase, while accounting is a concerned, it is like a summary phase. Accounting is a summary phase, but bookkeeping is like a recording phase, you will record there. And bookkeeping, it provides necessary data for accounting, and accounting starts where bookkeeping ends. So where bookkeeping is ends, from there accounting starts. So simple difference. Bookkeeping, it is a process concerned with the recording of transaction, but accounting, it is a process of summarizing of recorded transaction. Bookkeeping, it consists space for accounting, and accounting, it is considered as the language, it is a language of business. And bookkeeping, it's a financial statement. Financial statement do not have any part of this process. In this process, the financial statement does not do any part in bookkeeping, but in accounting, financial statements are prepared in this process on the basis of bookkeeping records. Managerial decision cannot be taken with the help of these records in bookkeeping, but managerial decision can be taken by the help of accounting. And there is no subfield of bookkeeping in the bookkeeping process, but there are several subfields in the financial accounting, management accounting, in the accountings. And financial position of the business cannot be said by using the by the help of bookkeeping, but by accounting we can say about the financial position of that business. So relationship is see, accountancy, the first process. So relation between accountancy and bookkeeping can be depicted like this chart. Bookkeeping is small part, accounting is in that part. In the accountancy part, you will learn, you know about the accounting, what is accounting. In accountancy, see, chartered account, you are learning accountings, what are accountings. In that accountings, now you are learning the bookkeeping in that chapter, like that it is. Okay, next, after this, let us know. The next is subfields of book of accounting. There are not only one fields in accounting, you learned as accounting as subfields like managerial accounting, financial accounting, you learned in that difference between bookkeeping and accounting. So financial, now let us know about the subfields. The first one is financial accounting. So financial accounting, it covers the preparation and interpretation of financial statements, and it has some of the communication to the users of that account. So it will have some communication with the users in that account, and it is historical in nature, and it is recorded as the transaction which had already been occurred. It is recorded as the transaction that has already been occurred. It is as done. The financial step of the financial final step of that financial accounting is the preparation of whether we have got profit or loss, and also and profit and loss account, and also we have balance sheets, and it primarily it helps in the determination of the net results for an accounting period and financial position on the given data. It will see next the next subfield of accounting is management accounting. It is concerned with the internal reporting to the managers, to reporting about the state, about the business. Informing the managers about the financial statement situation of that company, and to discharge the financial functions of the stewardship, planning, control and decision making for helping the managers to do the planning, decision making, and management need varieties of information to take a correct decision, and the different ways of grouping the information and preparing reports are described by managers. For discharging their functions, they are referred as managing account. A very important component of managing account is cost accounting, which deals with the cost ascertainment and cost control. It deals with the control of the cost. So management account will be dealt with a final level of chartered accounting course. It is like final level of chartered accounting course. Next, cost accounting. The technology of cost accounting published by the Institute of Cost and Management Accounts, that was in the England, they defined that the process of accounting for cost, which begins with the recording of income and the expenditure, or the basis on which they are calculated, on the basis of which income and expenditure are calculated, and ends with the preparation of the report of that cost they have made. And cost accounting will be covered by the intermediate course IPCA and financial course of the chartered account curriculum. Next, social responsibilities of accounting. So the demand of social responsibility accounting stems from, it is from increasing some social awareness about some undesirable byproducts of the economic activities. As already discussed earlier, social responsibility accounting is concerned with accounting for social costs incurred by the enterprise, and social benefits are also created by the social responsibilities. Human resource accounting. Human resource accounting, it is an attempt to identify, quantify and report investments made in human resources of an organization that they are not presently accounted for and for under conventional accounting practice. Now, users of accounting information. Generally, users of accounting information, they are classified as two types: internal management and external users of outsiders. So management accounting, they are concerned with identifying of information required and also information management, well, in information requirements of the outsiders. Users are generally served as financial statement. So now there are some informations. Next is the relationship of accounting with other disciplines. So accounting is closely related with several other disciplines, and thus to acquire a good knowledge in accounting, one should be conversant with the with their portions of such disciplines they should have. In many cases, they overlap accounting. Sometimes they overlap accounting. This is not correct. The accounting should have a working knowledge of the related discipline. They should have discipline so that they can understand the overlapping areas and apply the knowledge for the discipline in their own work wherever they work possible. And he can take expert advice.